I am here with you. Now you know sex is my philosophy. Though I may never make history, I know making it is no mystery. From my point of view, I'm glad that I am here with you. Now the golden rule in my motto of one: do unto others as long as it's fun. I never look before I leap. I only sow what's fun to reap. So get out and live, 'cause I believe it's as blessed to give as to receive. If I gotta be anywhere at all, I'm glad that I am here with you. Now the kids are home, you know your neighbors real well. Let's live it up, I mean, who's gonna tell? Sex is starting a brand new trend, replacing the dog as man's best friend. From my point of view, I'm glad that I am here with you. My only thought since I turned 20 is to share the wealth, and I've got plenty. I only live by a simple creed: anyone's my friend if he's a friend in need. Life's too short not to have a ball. Why be had, why one, if you can have them all? I gotta be anywhere at all. I'm glad I'm here with you. You want knockers up? I do, too. What is your name, sir? What is your first name?
Nick.
Nick? That's close. I have a message for each and every woman sitting here tonight. Over the years, I have tried every formula known to man to make knockers bigger. But tonight, we have found the answer. Booze makes your boobies bigger. Come on, drink up! Come on, give her a jigger and watch them grow bigger. Look at all the women drinking here. Look at them. Every woman has taken her glass to her mouth and said, "What the hell? I got nothing to lose." Drink up. Don't drink gin. It makes them thin, honey. See? You're laughing down there. The little lady without the knockers here is hollering at me. Now, I've tried a lot of things to make them grow, honey. Remember I told you about putting the 5 sesame seeds in your navel that makes your boobies big? Oh, well, we know that didn't work. But it's just terrible, because I've tried everything. Nothing works. Oh, yeah, this booze, it ain't going to work. You know that. I know it. I had a fella say, "Soak your boobies in buttermilk." You ever try to get your knocker to a cardboard carton? Oh, that's smart. Right, sir? It's easy to drink booze than it is try to get your knocker through that damn carton. It really is. It's sort of silly. I want to tell every parent sitting here tonight, you don't have to worry about anything. It is now 9:15, and all your teenagers are home in front of the television set watching the Beatles. So mothers, don't even call home for the next hour, because if the phone rings, they won't answer it. If they don't answer it, you're going to worry about it. Those kids today, boy, can you believe them today? Can you believe the dances that they do today, sir? The jerk, the watusi, the frug. Can you believe it? Can you imagine a guy coming up to you, sir, and say, "Pardon me, sir, may I frug with your daughter?" Isn't that enough to scare the knot right out of your head? Oh, my God. And those little hip huggers they wear, and those little low-cut blouses, and they dance the Watusi, and they carry on, and their little boobies bounce around like crazy. Now I know why they call them dropouts. Oh, they're crazy. You've never seen anything. And the dancing and the wiggling and the carrying on. Oh, honey, I used to move that way 15 years ago when I meant it. Only I didn't do it until I was 18. Before that, I just laid there. And you know the Watusi that the teenagers are doing now? I just heard that the Watusi tribes in Africa are now doing a dance called the Teeners. That's when they all get around in a big circle and they have a Coke in one hand, a candy bar in the other, and they dance around until their face breaks out. Oh, I'm telling you, it's crazy today. You've never seen anything like it. Every time you go to the go-to or you watch it on television with the hullabaloo and the shindig, I don't know, when we were dancing years ago, it was such a pleasure. You know, you sort of walk up to a gal and you say, may I have this dance? You'd take her in your arms, you'd dance around, you'd bite her ear, you'd whisper little things in her ear. It was wonderful, I don't know. No, they don't. Honey, you've seen the kids today? They get on, the music starts, they rush out to the floor, and honey, I don't know how they can tell the girls from the boys. With the hair they're wearing, they can't tell. They just get out there, and I guess they just have to feel around. Honey, when we were dancing, it was like a vertical desire for a horizontal position. Now it's a vertical position for a horizontal desire. Just a few short years ago, when I was in my youth, we danced the prim and proper way. Now you know that's the truth. The kids today think dancing's nearly moving frantically. What they consider dancing now is still poontang to me. We used to dance together, but now they dance apart. The way we dance together, I still can visualize. With eye to eye and thigh to thigh, I feel his passion rise. We get all hot and bothered, then rush out to the car. Well, now they get the same results, but do it where they are. Oh, give it to him, Daddy! We used to dance together, but now they dance apart. They think the way they're dancing now is altogether new. It's something they invented that only they can do. They say that we're old-fashioned 'cause we don't move that way. If we didn't move that way, my friends, they wouldn't be here today. Let them help! We used to dance together, but now they dance apart. I'm going to learn to twist and fruit, now just you wait and see. It looks like that's the only way that I'll get on TV. I can't see why stations let kids bump and grind. In fact, if they can do those dances, why can't I do my act? Knockers on television, I'm ready! I'm gonna have some more booze. So come on, drink up, girls. Once with the right hand, then with the left hand, then with the right hand, then in case it works, you don't want to have one knocker down on the floor, you know. You feel good, don't you? If I had your knockers, I'd feel great every day of my life. Oh, there's another pair of big boobies. Hi, how are you, darling? know, you sort of walk around here and you see them all over the place. That's all right.
Oh, well, you've been drinking for years, haven't you, darling? God bless her. See, don't be embarrassed, honey. You're not the only one. There's loads of big knockers here tonight.
Oh, I'm sorry, sir. You can't see them from where you're sitting, but they are scattered down here. One there and there, one over there. And there's one over there behind the drums. There's a lady who has real heavy knockers. She has them laying in two gimlet glasses. And those green cherries make them look so funny. When you girls get up in the morning, I know you're so used to having that cup of coffee and everything, but forget it. Go right over to the bar in your house. Give yourselves a good belt of booze. And you won't have any bra on or anything. You'll just be there in your house coat. And you'll look at them and say, "Goo, get big, baby. Come on there, boobs, get big." And believe me, before 11 o'clock, you'll be so drunk, you'll think they're big. We're going to do our song. As most of you know, I think it was 1960 when we put out the Knockers Up album. Ever since that, I've often felt that we women have a cause in this world today. And with this cause, we have a national anthem. Ladies, are you ready? Knockers up! Knockers up! Knockers up! Oh my God, my turtle died. Ladies, get your knockers up. 1, 2, 3, 4. Up, 2, 3. Throw your shoulders back and get your knockers up. Up, 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 up. Come on there, honey. Throw those shoulders back. Get up. Big smile. Come on, shoulders back. Come on, honey. There. Doesn't that make your navel tingle when you do that? Ladies, I have said that man was born to thrust upon us with the biggest and the best that they have. I feel that it is our turn now to rise and unite and thrust back at them with the biggest and the best that we have. In order to do that, I want every lady sitting here in this audience tonight to march proudly through the Anaheim Bowl with the knockers held high, flapping in the breeze, proving that we have something to give in this crazy world today. Ladies, are you ready to commence the march of the knockers? Everybody march. Back to the show, just round about. Throw your knockers up and out. Hut, 2, 3, 4, and a hut. 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 Ladies, you're not marching. You don't have to have large knockers to do this march. Just do as the men do. Think big, right? Back to the shoulders, round about. Throw your knockers up and out. Hut, 2, 3, 4, and a hut. 2, 3, 4, and a hut. 2, 3, 4, and a hut. 2, 4. Yeah. When you girls go back into the office, I want you to do me a little favor. Want you to stand in front of the boss's office for just one moment. Mentally take yourself in hand. Throw your shoulders back. Get your knockers up. Put a big smile on your face. The boss will take one look at you and he'll say, "Hot damn, Beatrice got her knockers up." Knockers up, everybody. Tonight is our night. The booze is the only way to go, sir. You know, when you talk about people who drink, they say, "Oh, isn't that terrible?" Those terrible people who drink and carouse and carry on and covet thy neighbor's wife and all that. Oh, well, really. I don't trust anyone who doesn't drink. Am I right? I don't trust them. I mean, alcoholism is another problem. I'm not talking. I'm just talking people with social drinking who can sit around and get bombed out of their minds with friends. Isn't that sort of a fun thing? Now, you look like a good old drinking fella. Fella who likes to have a few little nips with some sociable friends. And what happens if you get one guy in the group who says, no, thank you, I'll have a 7-Up. Don't you want to belt him in the mouth? Are you a married lady, the lady with the big knockers? Are you married, sweetheart? How many years have you been married? 2 months! 2 months! Oh, thank heavens you have come here in time. It is not too late for me to help this young woman, this innocent little bride of only 2 months. Oh, you know, this makes me feel so good. Of all the times I've yelled and hollered and screamed and carried on about everything that I talk about, it's always nice to know that maybe I can help one or two people here. It's too late for most of you couples. What can I say to you that you haven't done over and over and over again? But a newlywed, a woman just breaking into the cone of life, bursting forth with her big boobs into a beautiful life of happiness, walking down that white, white path. Oh, golly, and gumdrops. That makes you feel good. Dear, I feel that it's my duty to help this young lady. And I know that this man is more going to appreciate the things that I'm going to say to his wife. And only pray and only hope that you have not made the silly mistakes that I'm going to mention. It's sort of, you've read hints from Heloise in the paper, haven't you, dear? Well, these are little hints from Rusty. Because you see, what some men don't realize is that a woman, God bless her, young as she is, gets a very, very strange impression of the world of sex that we live in. It starts when she is very, very young. Frightening but true, because when she's very young, the sense of curiosity sets in and she learns about it. That's what it's called when they're very young. You're too old to remember that, so. And as she grows older, the it sort of passes away and it grows into another thing. No, it grows into a little more educated situation where she understands it to be the mysterious thing. Still, she doesn't have a name for it because you don't know what to call what you don't know. What you only hear whispered. And you go to ask your mother and she says, I don't know, ask your father. And your father says, don't bug me, ask grandma. And grandma's the funniest of all. She's sitting there going, oh, you love it, you love it. Meanwhile, the kid didn't get any answers. And it doesn't take him long to meet that certain someone, that beautiful male component, that beautiful masculine thing, the great white father, anything you want to call it. And he has convinced her, oh, heavens, that togetherness, you two can make the most beautiful music. He needs you to be exactly what he wants to be, the great man. No matter what his business is, without you, he is nothing. He feels this, he tells you this, you feel needed, you feel wanted. Oh, this is going to be absolutely beautiful. The thing has finally spoken to you. Oh, my heaven. Oh, yeah, it talks. You don't know. What is she prepared for what it is going to say? Is this young, innocent maiden going to make the correct impression on the thing.
Oh, when her mother is telling her out of one ear, she's saying, don't worry, your honeymoon night is the best night you'll ever have. Most beautiful night in your whole life. You'll never forget it. You'll never forget it. And grandma's sitting there saying, ha, it's a drunken brawl, you'll hate. Yes, this is fantastic. But after all, you must make that correct impression. So, when this thing is presented to the young bride, the young maiden, oh, God bless that beautiful time, when the great white father has finally taken the most educated thing he has and presented it to you, and believe me, young lady, this is yours for the rest of your life. You must treat it with kindness, but you must know what you are treating. And the first time you look at it, please do yourself a favor. Don't giggle at it. Whenever you don't look at it and say, oh, George got one just like that. If you say that, you're going to have to explain who the hell George is. And that's one thing a bride must never do with all the love in her heart, is ever confess anything to him. You don't know any other man in your life, my dear. You only went out with two other fellas and your mother was with you. You don't know nothing. Don't confess to him. I know when a woman is in love, she feels like she must tell all. She must bare her soul to this man who is going to take her under his arm for the rest of his life. She feels as if, well, honey, he ain't your minister, he's your husband. Don't tell him nothing. But on the other hand, he is not an innocent maiden. He's been around. Oh, God, has he been around? And there has been other brought. Honey, there, and you gotta find out who it is. And you bug him until you find it out. Nag him to death. Say, come on, there was another girl. You went with her, when you came with her. Who are you? What did you marry me for? Tell me about her. What was her name? What? Come on, you did it with her. I know you did it. You're that kind of a fellow. I know how you are. You did it with her. You did. Tell me, what was her name? And he will get so nervous and so bumped, he'll pick out any name he can think of and say, it was Alice, now leave me alone. Don't you ever forget that name. Because there's going to be a time in your married life, it may not be the first year or the fifth or the tenth, but there's going to be a time in your married life when you're going to have a fight that you're losing. Oh, girls, this is the worst kind. Because we never lose a fight, you see, sir, never. We win them all, no matter what. We use sex, the children, we use every gimmick in the world, and you gotta fall for one of them. But girls, this fight, you've used sex and the children, and he wouldn't have none of it. You are wrong, and he knows you're wrong, and his stupid, idiotic, logical mind is gonna pin you to the floor. And that is not a comfortable feeling. He is yelling and screaming and kicking the furniture and hollering and cursing, and you're saying, shh, the neighbors, what's the matter? You're in the hell with a neighbor. And he, oh, I mean one of those real doozy of a fight. You know what I'm talking about? When he takes a breath, you look at him and say, what did you do with Alice? And he'll say, who the hell is Alice? Honey, it's 10 years. He don't remember what the hell he said yesterday, let alone 10 years ago. And boy, he's going to forget all about the fight, and he's going to bug himself with Alice. Because any man worth his salt every 10 years has got to worry about something named Alice that he can't remember. Now, you're not writing this down, and you're going to forget the whole thing. You see what can happen when you confess something? Thank you, sir. Booze it up, it'll make your boobies bigger. Not you, sweetheart. God, no. It's wild. Just a drink booze. Are you a married lady, the little lady in white? Are you married? How many years have you been married?
10 years? Oh, my heavens, you're lucky. You would never believe it. Really? You must have married when you were a very small infant.
Really?
Yes. Isn't it some... Do we have any of our innocent young maidens with us tonight? Any of the girls, the young girls, young daters sitting here who might have been helped with that little situation I was talking about? Are you gals married? You two kids with the fellas, are you married to these gentlemen? Huh? Uh-huh. No, no virgins at all here tonight. This fella sitting with two ladies, are you married? To both of them. Oh, that's beautiful. I love a man who has enough to give to more than one. And both the ladies are very happy. They're smiling. Yeah, yeah. What'd you say? Oh, yeah. She says she has a Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, and he has it Tuesday, Thursday, and Saturday. And Sunday, he rests. He has to. They lay him out in the cot, and they don't wake him up till Monday evening. Poor thing doesn't have to work at all. Really. You don't call that work, do you, sir? Making love to a lovely lady is never work. It's always part of your business, part of your life, part of making you click. Isn't it wonderful? How many years have you been doing this gracious thing to one particular lady? 18 years. Just giving it to her for 18 years? Oh, isn't... Oh, my... I think he's given an awful lot. Don't you feel as if all these years and all the wonderful things and after all the sneaky times... Oh, you... Just as long as he gives it to you, you don't worry about it when you get it. That's a good lady, right?
She's truthful.
She is truthful. I think there's not, you know, women are not as honest as they should be. And I know we have some honest women here tonight. I can tell just by talking to the audience. Just to prove the sense of honesty that we have in the female population here tonight, I want every woman sitting here tonight who knows she's going to get lucky tonight go, yahoo! Yeah, out of 500 people, we had about 18 yahoos. Do you think they're liars, sir? You can stand there and say that these gracious women who had guts enough to scream out that they wanted it, they wanted it, they let him know, because he was shocked. One fella fainted over here when she hollered. You don't believe it. Well, I suggest that you take your car and visit 18 homes tonight. You'll never make the third house, horny. Unless you're planning a little get-together with the three couples you're sitting with here, you know. That's always a fun game. Oh. Now, I love that story about the couple that married 10 years. God bless them. They were celebrating an anniversary, decided to go to Las Vegas. It was wild. It was wonderful. They invited the next-door neighbors. God forbid they should be alone. What the hell is that? After 10 years, they're going to celebrate with somebody. They sit around having dinner, and the husband says, you know, we've been married for 10 years. Let's do something different. Let's change partners. Everybody agree? 5 o'clock in the morning, the husband gets up. He leans on his elbow, and he says, gee, I wonder how the girls are doing. This joke isn't quite for you. You haven't been married long enough to understand it, darling. But I know most of the audience here tonight have been to Las Vegas, to the gambling area of our country. And it's the wildest place in the world. But if you go there for sex, forget it. For some reason or other, sex and gambling don't mix. Did you ever notice, especially if your husband likes to gamble a lot, if he's a real wild gambler, honey, you could lay stark naked on a crap table and he'd say, would you move your knocker, you're on my point, please.